Hi guys, welcome back. Another quick short video. Right now, as I said before, the SC2 chucks, a lot of people moan about the keys because they come these tiny little ones, and I made handles for mine, little wooden handles, makes it comfortable. And I said I'll probably show, I might do this one. I don't know whether I want it actually. I quite like this one. It sits on my magnet nice and I don't mind it, but they are more comfortable. Once I've done it, I'll probably like it. So I'm gonna make a handle for this one. I thought you might like to see how you do it. Now, I'm gonna go over there because I'm gonna do this with the router first to do a slot. Now, last time when I done those ones, I used my router table, but not everyone's got a router table. You might have a router. If you haven't got a router, then you're gonna have to do a bit with a chisel to chisel this out, or however you wanna do it. Okay, I'm gonna use a router. So I'm gonna go over there to my route, to my table. Well, Lisa's just gonna bring you round on the camera. She's working a bit freehand today, so yeah. Right, now, if you can see on me all right, I've already marked up the center and I've marked up the distance on the wood that I want to route, okay? That distance out. Ignore that line at the moment, that's if I cut it on the band. So I might not cut it down, I might actually just turn it on the lathe. Do it that way, it'll be quicker really. But right, I'm gonna mount this in my vise for the moment. Now I've just got, let me just unplug that for a second, safety. Right, in here I've just got a spiral, quarter inch spiral bit, okay? That's what I'm gonna use. Now I've already set my fence so that I'm gonna come down to the middle. You want to come just around and see this bit here? So I'm coming down to the middle, okay, and I've set my plunge depth so that I'm gonna be near enough, just under halfway. Now I might go a slight bit deeper because obviously when I turn this away, I'll see when I've put the handle in and see how far down it goes. I might go a little bit deeper because when I turn it away, I'm gonna turn some of this away as well. So I really want that set for the middle. Right, okay, so I'm going to plug that in and get this routed. Okay. Right, now I'm gonna be here, so are you gonna see, or do you wanna go up that way a little bit? Right, okay, I'm just gonna take a couple of light passes. I'm not doing it all in one go. I could, but I'm not going to. Right, okay. Right, so guys, this is what we've got, this slot in here, and now my key is going to fit up inside there. Right, now I might go, I can see how far that it's going to be. It's going to be tight there until I turn it down a little bit. I think I'll go, I'm in that far, I think I'm going to go a little bit deeper just so the key's gonna be at the middle once I've turned this around. Because when I turn it round, I'm gonna be turning some off of this edge as well. So, right, all I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna plunge that down, stop it, undo my depth, take it up. Maybe not as much as that, maybe about that much deeper. That's it. Right, I'm just going to go that much deeper with it. Okay, right, so let's go.
Right,
haven't put dust extraction and that on it. It's not that much. It's only a little bit. Right, okay. Get all that sawdust out of there. Right, okay, yeah, I'm down a good enough bit now. Right, so that means the key will be in the centre when I'm done. Right, Lisa's going to bring you back round there now. To the lathe.
Table legs and everything in the way.
She's on a tripod, so she's got to carry it round. Oh, right, okay, guys, so I've marked my centre. Okay, I've marked my centres on here. Got my step centre. This is a piece of cherry, by the way. Got my step centre. I've got my ring centre. Okay. Right, so I'm just going to put this between centres. Well, I'm just going to rough it down to round now. So I'm going to put my face shield on. Have you got a good enough view there? Or did you want to come right in and over?
Yeah, I'm wondering whether it's better to come over.
Let me just have a. I'll just help Lisa move the camera in a bit. Right, sorry guys. A little bit of a adjustment. Yeah, it should be alright, yeah?
Yeah.
You're okay there?
Yeah.
Right, okay. Just going to use my small roughing gouge. Okay. I'm going to turn this around at first. I've got more. That's it. That's better. Right, we're nice and round. I'm going to get it down near enough to the diameter I want. So I can have a look. Right, okay, yeah, I've got plenty of remove key. Right, key's in, so I can go down a bit more there, and then I'm going to be tapering it round a bit, okay? I might even pull it and go a little bit off centre, I don't know. I'll see. When I get down to that. Right, okay. Can you go down a little bit more with it? Right, okay. Have another look. Right, the ends are still in, so I can still go a little bit more there if I want. See, because I'm going to be tapering it down. So, yeah. I can go a little bit more. Like I say, if you have that problem, you can go a little bit deeper. That's it. Right, I'm just at the ends there now. Okay. So now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to mark it. Where those bits are. Where my key comes to. So, I want to sort of finish just past that. Okay. Now what I'm going to do, move this out and keep that there, and I'm actually going to just take this, move that back a fraction, that's it, that's better. Right, I'm actually just going to drop this, take it out of centre, take it off at the centre, and I'm just dropping it down pretty much to the to where the ring of the centre is. So just dropped it down a few mil. Hang on, let me make sure this one's right, in the right place. Yeah. That's it, right, okay. So I've moved it down to there. So as you can see, it's now off center. Get that moved in there. Right, we'll start it up again. And now, see the shadow. I can see I've got a shadow there where it's off centre. Right, I'm gonna look at that. Okay, I brought it round to that, but I haven't reduced that. Okay, so I've reduced the back, but I haven't reduced that. So now, I'm going to put it back onto centre. Onto centre. And that was... Nope. That's not centre. That's centre. Right, so now I'll put it back onto centre. No, actually, sorry, hang on. Let me get back. No, I'm going to leave it off centre. So I can see what's going to happen to that. I'm going to leave it off centre. Yeah, that's it. Right. Now I'm just going to bring the ends in. That's it. And it's going to be off. It's gone off centre, so that's going to be all right now. So, come off of this rough and gouge. Start it back up. Get your pencil lines a bit better. Yeah, I can keep it like that now. Right, let's come in with the spindle gouge. Oh, got a fire there. Do this with your, yeah, that's going to be all right. Do this with your skew if you want. Do your bowl gouge, whatever you want to do. Do your carbide. It's a little bit wider, thicker that side. Oh, yeah, just bring this one round a little bit. That's it. Right, okay. Right, now, I'll do a little sand on that. Full handle, so... I don't want it ultra smooth. I'll say it's a tool handle. It's not going to stay pretty for long. Right, now I'm just going to use my skew
support come in. Right, there we go. Take those two off. I've just very quickly, I can use my drill for this. Right, okay
guys, that's that bit done. That's the turning done. Right, and now all I've got to do is, that's it, go and epoxy that in. You all know how to mix up a bit of epoxy glue, so you don't need me to show you that. Basically, with the last ones, I just held it in my vise, mixed up some epoxy, poured it in, left it to dry. Now, like I said, if you want to, you can stick a couple of rare earth magnets in there. Then when you want to put it on your lathe bed, it'll magnet and it'll stick to it. That way it can't fall through. Or if you want to put a couple drilled out and put a couple in there, then you can stick your key wherever you want to do it. For me, it doesn't matter because I stick my key up on here. Okay, my key will go up there. But yeah, that's actually a really nice handle now. So I'm going to actually change. Now I've done it, I think, yeah, I want that. So there you go, guys. Hope that helped. Like I said, when you move it off centre, yeah, don't put it back to centre. I was going to put it back. No, leave it off centre. But that's how you can avoid taking that down. So if you do it, just move it over that little bit, and that way you'll get it all finished even. So there you go. Look at that. It'd be nice if Record Power done with a handle like that, wouldn't it? But then, what would I have to do? There you go. See you on the next one, guys. Hope that's helped. Hope that makes your handle a bit more comfortable. Especially for you poor old chaps, you know, can't get hold of your handles right. There you go. Sort it out for you. See you later, guys. Toodle pip.
Bye, guys.